Look around the room real quick. See if you can find people that you've connected with so far. See if you can catch their eye contact and just give them a little head nod like, hey, stuff. How many of you have had a conversation since you've been here that you may not have ever had? Collaborative learning. But that is a good thing. Yes. Okay. And then I'll make them live in the space a little bit. So how many of you have met somebody before and totally forgot their name? So there's two reasons that happens, I would say. So the first reason is our brains just aren't wired to remember language and numbers. So anybody with a speculative background in general, language and numbers have to work short-term memory and then they hop out. That's the reason. Phone number is choked with a hyphen because a few 8-pound blocks can't contain the time you get to call somebody. The other reason, which is much more intense and impersonal, is when you heard the name, you never actually heard it because who are we thinking about? This person. And so we're going to talk about our brains. If you've forgotten here. But I use other brains that capture the visual imagery. So I was sitting in some of the sessions and talking with you. I saw lots of awesome notes being scribbled down and lots of learning being processed. And you share that visually a little bit. So there's images. There's some really game cards, and there's a picture on one side and a card on the other. And so I'm going to invite you to create an image or go find and choose an image that represents some learning that you absolutely do not want to forget when you leave here. So 6 months from now, you are running your own programs. What is the learning you absolutely do not want to forget? For example, I'm going to choose a picture of a door, so a blue door. I was in one of your sessions, and I don't actually remember who, but we were talking about giving students increasing access to a lunch conversation with Karen. Hi. So increasing access to networks and social capital that we otherwise never have. So the right idea is talking about platforms and what it looks like. So don't just come back and just email all this really stuff. At the end of that is creating, on the other side of that, on the real world side of that, is creating actual conversations and connections that really shift the path of some of these lessons. And so there's some specific ways that I feel like I have done presentations about how to better give students access that are not currently getting access. So for me, it represents giving access to something else. So this is going to be my takeaway memory. My invitation is once you pair whatever that learning is with an image, is that you get to keep this card and put it on your keyboard or dashboard or clipboard or whatever kind of board you want to put it on. But this is one of the 6 months from now, you're like, right, I had that conversation at lunch, or I was in that session and I had this idea. So sometimes it'll take a little bit longer, but picture on an image. And the philosophy that nothing is totally random, that you can pick anything with anything else if you're creative enough. So the table back with more images over here as well. So in this case, I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you. Thank you.
session so far. In general, it's not in the world, but it's kind of like a good way to touch on the community. I appreciate everyone sharing the wins, the challenges, just being really open and honest. It was set up to think about how we can help each other, how we can be a better partner to you. So I just appreciate the honesty. It means a lot. This is tough work that we're all striving towards. Thank you.